Okay, so I thank the organizers for inviting me, and it's a pleasure to speak in this conference in honor of Professor August, that I know for many years. So I want to speak about a continuation of some recent work that I did. So I'm speaking about the work on the talc homology that is published in Asterisk, and my work with Orgogozo on the p-dimensional fields. And it is also related to question studies by Kato in the early 80s. So the first part of my talk will be so application to commutative algebra of my results on the talc homology, so the theory of multiplicities. And so this uses, doesn't use the mixed, it uses coefficients L, which are invertible, where L is invertible in the residue field. But still, one is to know this to understand what I want to do for p-torsion coefficient in the mixed characteristic case. And also it is simpler. So in the p-adic part, I will have at least three approaches to proving things, and it will be a bit sketchy because one is to verify things which are not exactly said in the literature, one is to prove some compatibility, there are questions of sign and other things, and this on that. So it's really and also some of it was just thought when I prepared for the lecture, slightly strengthened what I could prove. So the first topic is about multiplicity for a ring, for a local Noetherian ring homomorphism. So actually, I will assume the dimension of D and the fiber dimension is zero, and let us say O is normal and excellent. So now maybe I'm writing too small. Okay, so in any case, I want to construct something which is like the degree of this extension divided by the residue degree in the case of finite extension, let us say, of Noetherian local rings. So I want to, so more specifically, there is the classical notion of a multiplicity for an M primary ideal in the small ring. So I can look at the multiplicity of the extension divided by the multiplicity of Q. And I claim that this is independent of the primary ideal Q, and it lies in Z1 over P, where P is the characteristic exponent. So this extends something studied by Suslin and Voivodsky in the red book on so when they consider the notion of a family of cycles parameterized by a scheme. So there's then a family of cycles of finite type, but the scheme was actually just geometrically unibranch. So the idea that when you specialize a cycle, some equidimensional cycle at a closed point, you get something with coefficient Z. Possibly the residue characteristic will appear. So to prove such a thing, you can try easy cases. So if the residue, so of course you can assume the rings are complete. So if the residue extension is separable, then we know that in the complete case, you can somehow have a unique, formally smooth.
I'm sorry, what's the definition of E of Q?
E of Q is like in commutative algebra books, that is, you take the length of O modulo powers of Q as a polynomial in N for large N, and you take the coefficient of the largest powers of N with some factorial. So it's the same thing as in commutative algebra books, such that for the maximal ideal of the regular local ring, you get multiplicity 1.
Multiplicity,
I said. Okay. Multiplicity, at Q. Yes. And if Q is generated by regular sequence, then it is the length of the ring mod Q. Okay. So now, In the case, I assume the ring to be normal to, otherwise there will be maybe several branches, it will complicate the formulas that, and also I use results on the talc homology which are stated in this case. And the excellent will come from the method, so in the case of Susi and Verovatsky, they don't need excellent, but things are of finite type, and you can even remove Noetherianity from what they do, if you are careful enough. So in my case, I have this formally smooth map. So by general results, all fibers are geometrically regular. This is also normal. And then I have a map. If it is the same residue field, it must be finite. And then it has some degree, which is an integer. And this degree is the integer in this case. So more generally, if the residue field extension...
What is the ring in the middle?
No, in the middle, you just use the EGA theorem that allows you to extend the formally smooth algebras over the residue field, complete Noetherian local. So this is just the usual material. There is a unique... Okay, I'm just assuming that...
Okay.
But of course, K prime is not algebraic. It's just... But
yes.
So in most cases, this in particular... Now, of course, if K prime is finite... over a separable extension, then the same thing holds. You get just you have to divide, take this degree divided by the degree of this. And of course, you can make this finite purely inseparable. So you see that only a power of p appears. So this, in particular, gives the case studied by Susi and Verovatsky. And in this case, you don't have to pass the completion because you are working geometrically. Okay. And there are indeed examples where the p appears in the denominator, like given in Susi and Verovatsky, or given, for example, by you take the family of p cycles, degree p cycles, let us say, in let's say A2 or AM, where m is bigger than 1, so it's parameterized with a symmetric power. Anyway, you kind of take the universal cycle and you take the diagonal, so to speak. You can see that there you get you must get the generic point of the diagonal of the parameter space. You must get this phenomenon, I think. So in any case, this doesn't necessarily always the case, but you can also look at the case where the inseparability index is finite. So roughly speaking, I can make this separable by adding, by tensoring with a purely inseparable extension, by compositum with some finite extension, I get something separable, and the same argument works. So, and in particular, the index of inseparability, that the length of the tensor product is a bound for the denominator that appears in the multiplicity. Now, So now, to prove this in general, my first approach uses my results on a talc homology, and then I found that actually one can do it by elementary methods with intersection theory that I will sketch. So maybe I should use this stuff to... Now, is it, did I hide it, something?
Okay. No, okay. It's okay.
All right. So, I assume, in Exposé 17 of the asterisk book on my work, so there is the following result. So if I have a strictly...
Maybe you should write a little bit over the answer.
Okay. So suppose that X is a strictly local... excellent scheme of dimension D, then I can consider, so first of all, there are cohomological dimension results, so the fraction field, let us say normal, so the cohomological dimension of the fraction field is D, and the cohomological dimension of x minus the closed point is 2d minus 1, where L is invertible, that is not the characteristic of the residue field. And then there is a canonical way to identify the local cohomology with coefficient, let us say, lambda d, where lambda is the usual coefficient z modulus some power of L with lambda. And this is compatible with transition maps. And the transition maps are defined using branches of curves. So I have my closed point, and I have a little curve with generic point y. And then if I have a class in the cohomology with support in y of something, then I can pass to, so this is a geometric one, but actually the I can use the Hochschild-Serre spectral sequence, so essentially like coupling with the Kummer, maybe some sign, the generator of H1 of KY, so I get some class in the, at least in top degree, you have one term in the spectral sequence, a class in support in Y of the punctured spectrum, then it goes to the cohomology of X minus X, and then it goes to the local cohomology. So up to some sign questions which are studied carefully, I hope, then this will, so anyway, there is some Tate twist that appears here, and so and also you have to divide, you have to normalize it and divide by the residue field extension. When you normalize this branch to make it a DVR, you have some inseparable extension here, and you have to divide by this degree. And then those isomorphisms are compatible. So in particular, and so they are uniquely defined by this. Okay, now, so my idea is to, when you study my map of local rings with zero-dimensional special fiber, both of them are degree D, you can assume they are strictly Enzelian, and excellent, well, you complete, and this, the higher one I didn't assume, but you can easily reduce to this case, and even normal. So, and then you can look at the induced map on local cohomology, H to D X of spec O to H to D X spec O prime, and with coefficient, let us say, ZLD. So then I get a number in ZL. Okay, but then I prove, so let us say that I prove that it's equal to this ratio of multiplicities. Then I am done because I can use all L different from P. And now to prove it is equal to this ratio of multiplicity, so when the residue field is infinite, so Q is integral in the sense of ideal theory over an ideal generated by a system of parameters of the local ring. And in this case, you can construct a cohomology class by the Kummer, cupping the Kummer coboundary, or minus the Kummer coboundary, actually, to. So the HFI defines a class in H1 on chi fi in H1 of the open where fi is non-zero with coefficients in ZL1. Then I can take this coboundary, which is a class, a cohomology class H2 with support, the cup holders has support in a closed point. Okay, so now, so I have this definition, and I claim that this is equal to the multiplicity of the ring modulo the ideal times the canonical generator that I define. Okay, so to prove this, you have to look to do induction on D, you look at the definition, if you know it, the point is that F2 and up to FD okay, so now I follow. So the point is that you have a curve defined by F2 up to FD equal to zero, and at the all maximal point, generic point of irreducible components, I know by induction that I get the right thing, and I also know how to, that each each of those classes gives by some canonical way this class, and then I can look at this formula and compare it to the transition maps, and so it comes out that, again, you have to treat the signs properly, that this is equal to that. And then it is clear from this, once I prove this, then of course this class pulls back to the corresponding one, so it is clear that you get the ratio of multiplicities. Okay, so this is a cohomological proof. Now suppose we want to do geometric proof. So it's not related to the other subject, but still it is it's interesting, I think. So for the geometric proof, I want to use different birational models of X. So I have a map of strictly local things, but actually I want to look at divisors of branches, one-dimensional, but the idea is to prove it again by induction. So in particular, I have to prove that, if you look at what I proved, also since, as a corollary of the result, in particular, you get that the map of punctured spectra is surjective. Why? Because it's by induction, and it's enough to prove it that the generic point of curves lie in the image, because otherwise you can localize the corresponding thing and apply induction in the, well, in the catenarian that you can assume it's Xn, so universally catenarian and so on. So now, since my classes come from curves, any curve gives by some coboundary. If there is a curve, so the class on the punctured spectrum comes from, is supported on any reducible curve. If there is one which misses the image, then the class will be zero here. So it must be surjective. Okay, but now, the idea is that if you have a curve in the regular locus, and after some blowing up, actually, you get some, you take a blow up of some primary ideal and normalize, so you get some normal birational model, even isomorphism on the punctured spectrum, with some exceptional divisor, which is in the regular locus, also regular, so this curve cuts it transversely. And essentially, you are looking at something associated, that's the generic point of this component of the exceptional divisor. So the strategy for the geometric proof would be to define this invariant for generic points of the irreducible components of the special fiber, which is not so difficult. But still, I don't know that everything is hit by the image. Then I want to prove that they are equal. So I have some blow x, which is, I assume, normal, and I consider the corresponding normalized blow up of x prime. And then on the special fiber, I have a map. So actually, I have residue field. So I have a projective k prime scheme mapping to a projective k scheme. And this map is, after extending this scheme to K prime, it becomes a finite morphism. So you can use usual degrees. Anyway, you can define this invariant at generic points. Then I want to prove it's equal. What the formula that I get is equal for. So the idea is to that any two irreducible components of the special fiber are connected through codimension 2 points. Then I can use resolution of singularities for surfaces, and I reduce to the normal crossing situation. And then for dimension, in this case, it is easy to compare the invariant here, the invariant there. Then this will give me the, now the formula that I have is also the following, that if you look at this multiplicity, there is the following formula that I can, if I fix P, a prime ideal of O, so I can look at the sum of all over Q over P, O prime over Q over P, and E, so I can do the corresponding invariant for localizations. Okay, this is still normal. This is not normal, but in the strictly Enzelian case, it is geometrically unibrach, and I can still define this invariant. So to prove this formula, you can reduce to curves, and then you use the talc homology approach. But then I can try to... So the idea is to use this to use P in the a curve touching the regular, whose generic point is the regular locus, to define what this should be, prove it is independent of this curve. Then, after I do this, I can prove that it gives the ratio of multiplicities, because I can, for an ideal generated by F1FD, I can arrange that the generic point of F2FD are in the regular locus. Then I can prove this for a surface, for a cube dimension 2, which lies in the regular locus using specialization to a curve. Then for a curve not in the regular locus, I can embed it in a surface and do this. I can use the formulas on multiplicity interpreted in another way to handle curves whose generic point is in the singular locus. So I didn't, though this was maybe a... In any case, I didn't have detailed notes, so I don't want to okay, so... Now, okay, so in the mixed characteristic case, so let me recall the following. So I want to, so there is a work of Kato on the Galois cohomology for a complete discrete valuation field. In particular, it computes the P cohomological dimension. So it's natural to introduce a notion of P dimension of a field of characteristic P, which, so you assuming that it's a finite P base.
So let's find the bigger.
Okay. So I have the P rank of K, which is the number of elements in the P base, plus O plus 1. And for this, you use the Cartier. So for any finite extension, if R is the P rank of K, so omega R is the same as the cycle, so there is a classical Cartier operator whose kernel is the closed form, and then there is this 1 minus the Cartier whose kernel is the tall sheaf of logarithmic differentials. So the condition is that if you look at this, which in some sense is like HR plus 1 morally in some general suitable generalization of the FPPF. So for R equal 1, it's like FPPF cohomology, some kind of...
Can you read what you've just written?
Okay, so you take something which morally should be HR plus 1 K prime is coefficient mu P tensor R. And this is given by, actually this is not defined in general, but Kato defined it to be this, anyway, I recall some old things which probably, okay.
So K prime is what?
So suppose you have a finite extension of K, and yes. Okay. So you consider this invariant, which generalizes things also related, so classical things like the Brouwer group, the P part of the Brouwer group, okay. Okay, so the idea is that you look at this notion of cohomological dimension, where if all of those are zero, you declare, yes, if all of them are zero, you declare the to be the P rank, and otherwise you add one to take into account that this can appear, okay? And
what happens if the P rank is infinite?
No, I don't consider it all this case, because all the work that it's based on the previous thing where the P rank is always finite. It's not, okay. Okay, so, and then for a Henselian discrete valuation field of mixed characteristics 0p, the p cohomological dimension of k is the p cohomological dimension of the residue field plus 1. So moreover, one can study the cohomology of k with coefficients in the basic, especially this kind of cohomology, which turns out to be the Milnor K group modulo p to the n by a canonical map. So this was isomorphic too. So this first shown by Kato up to questions on the characteristic p field, which was solved by Bloch, Kato, also by me. And then they studied, so one studies the filtration on this and associated so this is a canonical filtration coming from filtration of Milnor K groups, and one can describe the associated graded in good cases, so in particular in n equal 1. So in particular, there is a quotient of this coming from the fact that the Milnor K group maps to a Milnor K group of the residue field direct sum. So when you choose a uniformizer, you can do this. This is like the tame symbol, okay? And this is the tame symbol of the element times the uniformizer, like specialization map. And so if the P rank of K is R, then actually HR plus 2 of K with coefficients in mu p to the n tensor R turns out to be the H1 of, so via this, so no, actually you do this for the separate, so the Galois cohomology of the KR MK modulo p to the n, which let's say it's the new new and R in mean notation. So this is the co-kernel of also W omega R log. Okay. For the Drum-Witt complex, which can be defined, the Drum-Witt complex can be defined for rings which locally have a finite p basis, and then you get so this gives the top cohomology in the case where the p dimension is this plus one, and in the case where it is k, the top cohomology is r plus one. And it admits a map to no, excuse me. This should be R plus 1, because it will use H R plus 1. Yeah, so yeah, so by this will map to omega r omega n log of K by a surjective map. Okay, now I want to look at what could be, so to prove the generalization of just not of the precise structure, but just of the cohomological dimension, which but then the description at least of this for, and then also some version of what I can say about this in the higher dimensional local excellent mixed characteristic local ring case.
I can't read what is on it. It is W.
W
N omega R.
Yeah. W
N omega R.
W N omega R log. Okay. So so in my work with Sorgogos also, anyway, so using the technique that I use in the tile cohomology also, so I prove, so let us now have O to be an excellent normal of mixed characteristic 0p and residue field k with finite p rank. Then the cohomological dimension of O and also the cohomological dimension of O1 over P or of any open affine is equal to dim PK plus dim O. Of the fraction field, excuse me. Now, notice, however, that in this case, you can consider not just O1 over P, but there is also a characteristic P locus. Now, for the characteristic P locus, a tile cohomology with coefficient Z mod P is quite different. In coefficient, I mean, mod P coefficients is quite different because by, for affine seeing, by Artin-Schreier theory, you have only H0 and H1, so you get cohomological dimension statement quite easily. And so you, it doesn't matter. So when you want to consider the punctured spectrum, you, it does, you can assume that the shift is zero on the characteristic P locus. On the other hand, the affine opens which contain pieces of the P locus can have slightly higher by one cohomological dimension. So to compute the, now to describe now the cohomological dimension now for P torsion coefficient of the punctured spectrum. So there are several possible arguments. One argument in the case that I, so for the previous thing is using a covering by several affines, but this doesn't work of the punctured spectrum. On the other hand, you can deduce it from a cohomological dimension of fields of fractions and this work. And also you can use initializations along affine opens in P equals zero, and the general fiber will be, so again, by cohomological dimension result characteristic zero, there is an estimate for this. This can be also used to estimate the cohomological dimension. So in any case, I prove that the cohomological dimension of this is 2D plus one, well, it is less than or equal to. So the idea is that you look at a cohomology class, and so it's zero at the generic point, then you can try to look at a maximal open where it is zero, take a maximal point of the complement, and then use the information there on the punctured spectrum, and you can continue until you get, you, so you prove that the, when you have a class in high degree, it is zero, and when it is in this degree, it comes again from curves, contributions of curves. But the curves can be either of mixed characteristic or of pure characteristic. Okay. So Now, on the other hand, you can have you can get a lower bound using a finite projection because you can take the completion by Cohen structure theorem. This is finite over some standard complete local ring where I is a Cohen ring. And then you have a trace map on a tall cohomology of the punctured spectrum. Let us say with constant, with a constant coefficient, which is surjective using cohomological dimension result. And then you have to, so also there is a comparison to completion result, allow you to compare this cohomology with the one for the completion. Okay, then for the punctured spectrum of this, you can decomplete, and so you have the closed point of some, let us say, P D minus 1 over I. And then you can define a trace map from, if I have some cohomology on this P as a closed point, so I have cohomology class on the with coefficient in something on the punctured spectrum, so this is local cohomology on P. So this goes to cohomology of P, but if I take a shift which is zero on the special fiber, then I am in a situation where I can use a trace map for a tall cohomology, a proper Bayesian in a trace map, and actually I can compute it. So I can get for a suitable choice that comes from a curve, actually, so I get a map to the cohomology supported in, so this goes to the cohomology supported in the closed fiber, then this goes to the cohomology of the, finally, of spec I supported at the closed point, which is essentially the cohomology of the fraction field. So in this case, you get a map to the cohomology of the field of fraction of I. And so you can detect that some classes are non-zero. And so you can get equality here. Now, if I consider, I have the following proposition that H 2D minus 1 plus dim PK of spec O minus the closed point is with coefficients in some sheaf, P torsion et al sheaf, is generated by local cohomology with support in closed points of the punctured spectrum or any Zariski open or any non-empty open in the punctured spectrum. Now, first, using general cohomological dimension result, I get it's generated by the contribution of all curves. Then I have to only nice curves, in particular those with generic point lies in the regular locus. So, okay, so I need a moving technique. So roughly, if I have my picture of the punctured spectrum, and I have the generic point, let us say, of a curve, let us say, in the characteristics P locus, where I have less information in the local cohomology, I put it in a surface whose put it in a surface. Okay. So suppose I have a C in X, a curve. So I put it in a surface meeting the regular locus where P is not zero. Okay. Then in the regular locus, I have and also the place where, so I have by absolute cohomological purity, I have a map from lambda s, so for s prime in s, some open dense, I have maybe d minus 2 to d minus 4. Yes. Okay, so then what happens is that the cohomology class on the punctured spectrum, so I reduce, so first of all, I reduce it to nice coefficients, so the coefficients are the statement to constant, so by usual Visage arguments to, and using the information cohomological dimension to coefficient with the right A twist that I, then I can even make them to be extension by zero from some open, doesn't, then I have a contribution from the generic point of the curve, but actually it comes as follows. I have a map. So actually I get a cohomology class for this extension by zero from S prime to S minus the closed point. So I have a cohomology class on the punctured spectrum of S, which induces a cohomology class, so on the S minus point, to the cohomology on X minus the closed point. So if I want to prove the class coming from, now, so what happens is that by induction, the class, the cohomology class that I have for the punctured spectrum of eta after strict initialization comes from contributions of nice curves. So in particular, they correspond to such surfaces. And then for each of those contributions, I get actually a cohomology class on S, which induces the one on X. So then I reduce to verify the result on the for the surface case. And then I can normalize, and then I have a cohomology class which is zero generically, and it is zero at also at every generic point of a curve, therefore on the initialization. Then you have to prove that it is, so you want to prove that it comes from contributions of all curves except finitely many specified ones. So you have to make it zero on some open which contains the generic point of those curves. So you have so anyway, you have cohomology class with zero generically, zero initialization at this point, but then the point is that you have to approximate, anyway, you use the fact that the cohomology of the fields that we are looking at are generated by symbols, and you can use easier approximation method to so essentially I have something like so essentially I have I have some cohomology class in the fraction field of the initialization of each of the xi, and I have to to extend it to some cohomology class in the fraction field of S by some approximation. So once you have enough roots of unity, so again, by this information from the early 80s, for those kind of fields, you don't need the Bloch-Kato conjecture, you know that the cohomology generated by symbols, then you can use this approximation. So anyway, so this allows one to do this moving part. Now I want to get an invariant associated to the top cohomology. So a map like before for the complete discrete valuation field case. So So again, I have the P rank is R. So I want to get So I extend the coefficient by zero to the locus where p equals zero. And so okay, so to define those maps, I have the following. The top cohomology is generated by contributions of curves in an even one Swiss generic point of characteristic zero. So I can use the for the result of Kato to for each of those contributions, I know what I use the result for complete discrete valuation fields. And of course, the residue field becomes a finite separable extension, but I also have norm maps, which are actually isomorphisms on those things on the top. So it doesn't change this for a purely inseparable extension. So then I have to prove it is well defined. And to prove it's well defined, I use completion and some choice of Cohen ring, and so the argument using projective space. So this gives something depending on some choices. But since this is generated by contributions of curves, so it's independent of the extra choice. And so this actually is defined without assuming that the cohomological dimension is this, because you can pass to the separable closure of the residue field and use Galois action. Okay. And so it is also easy to see that it is surjective for separably closed, and even when the p dimension small k is r. So I want then to prove that this is an isomorphism. So So the theorem is that, let us say, alpha is an isomorphism, and beta is surjective for k equal to ks, and in the non separably closed case, the Galois cohomology of k with coefficient in kernel of beta is zero. And this actually gives you this first statement. And then there is a more refined version of this, which says that the kernel of beta is generated by the kernels by the U1 of the cohomology of the generic point of the of curves. So so here, this is defined by some inner K group. It has the canonical U1 sub, so the quotient is discover logarithmic differentials. So once you know that, since this is a filtration, which essentially a vector space quotient or quotient of vector spaces, you can then control the Galois action on the Galois cohomology on this is trivial. So, but in fact, I have some proofs that prove only two. And then a proof that proves also three. So I will try to sketch in the remaining time, not much time. Okay, I will try to sketch the basic idea of the proofs. So first, there is a Bertini argument to reduce to a surface. So I need a strong some local Bertini theorem. So roughly, I have a certain number of curves with generic points in the regular locus, and I want to find an irreducible surface which is regular at those points and which contains all of those branches, okay? So for this, I need a variant of some Bertini statements in the literature. So there are several papers, some paper of Fellner, and then Trivedi corrected it, and then some recent work with some Japanese authors. But I need a variant of this. I can state what one can see, show. So for example, in any case, maybe because of the time, I will not spend on this Bertini. Suppose that you prove some Bertini theorems, because it's a there are several commutative algebra techniques that go into that, but so then you reduce to the surface case, and then the you can use finite cover using cohomological dimension results. So in dimension two, I want to work like in again, like my paper with Sorgogos. Suppose that I put a Cohen ring, then I use, it's over a Cohen ring, then I can use EPS, and this also lies over some vid vectors for the maximal perfect subfield. I can use EPS theorem to make the special fiber geometrically reduced, and then I can change the residue field. In fact, I can also have a variant where I don't change its further extension to make this kind of generically smooth, and then this is algebraizable. So it's it comes from a relative curve over I, and then I can use by further extension I have the semi-stable reduction theorem, which has several proofs, including the one of anyway, this is the classical case of discrete valuation ring. Now So after some blowing up, so making the semi-stable reduction, I have some model. So I have some external curves that is, there is a part lying over the closed point of my original strictly local thing. Then I have the shift. Essentially, I'm considering, so this lies over spec I. And essentially, I consider an extension by zero of some lambda from the general fiber to this. So I consider, in fact, so I have some y over spec I. And I can consider the cohomology of y with support, let us say, there is a part over the closed point. So all the components except so some external ones, so corresponding to the original component of the locus where p equal to zero. And then I have some vanishing cycles for this situation. Now, in this case, so the vanishing cycles were started in the smooth case by Bloch and Kato, and then by Yodo in the semi-stable reduction case, but he assumes that the residue field is perfect, which is not essential, I think. So he studied it for things which are semi-stable, but also after extension of the residue field. So essentially, it works for things which are etal locally, smooth over something x1, xn equal to the power of the uniformizer. And it works, I claim that it works, I mean, with non, using the dry definition of the Ramvit. So he studies it using Milner K theory. So actually, one is to correct some point, like instead of this, you have to consider the Milner K theory of the general fiber of the strict initialization. In any case, so using the techniques of, so one shows that the cohomology shifts are generated by symbols, they have a canonical filtration, and essentially the other associated grades are coherent, and there is a top. So I will be interested just in the top. So I have cohomological dimension result. So I have to look just at H1 of the top R psi. So the top, so one can show that there is only H1 with support in Z, and I have to consider the top R psi, and then there is a quotient of this which is given by logarithmic differentials. Well, actually, it was not defined. Anyway, it defines something which should be the log, the Ramvit, but I don't know how much this is developed. Anyway, he has some definition by hand of this. So, Yodo. So this is a paper in 1988. So I have not studied if there are other references, I don't know if there are other references that complete the point. In any case, this is only one of the approaches. So one needs to improve upon because of some conditions and so on. And also one has to prove compatibilities. So the point is that essentially it's the coherence of the, so I have to, in any case, I have information on the cohomology, again, it improves, so one has the Ram, so there is the fact that the top, the Ramvit, is a dualizing complex on the scheme which has a local P basis, and then it behaves well under F upper Schrick. So this is in a cadality, this, but under a strictly assumption working over a perfect field, so I need it in a more general context, and actually helped the cadal at that time for doing, anyway. So this, allows one to compute the cohomology, the top cohomology of the log differential and of the, I mean, of the Milne shifts. So essentially, let's say if X is regular of dimension n with field of constant k separably closed, then I have to. In any case, I have an isomorphism given by a suitable trace map. So anyway, so what I get is a certain map using this vanishing cycle description. I have to prove it is behaves well on all curves, so it's compatible with my map defined by curve contribution. So then again, I can make extensions. I reduce a curve after an extension to a, and changing the model to something that cuts transversely, and then I can see I can up to some sign check this. So this will give the vanishing of H1K because of things which are essentially coherent. And then there is another approach which is more rigid analytic, avoiding the precise description of Yodo. So this. So again, after some extension, essentially I can have a model where I now extend it to a proper thing, a proper formal scheme, and then I algebraize it, where I have those A1s, so the other curves will be, it will be compactified to, so that those will be P1s. So then I have some rigid kind of, I'm looking at the cohomology modulo some rigid disks at infinity. And then I look at my trace map, and again, so I will have some Galois cohomology. So there will be some contribution from H1 of a rigid disk of an algebraically closed field, which is not zero in the periodic world, but it again is involves some coherent information. And so I can then manage to get triviality of Galois cohomology. This is a different argument, which doesn't really require to have the semi-stable thing, but it requires to use some rigid. Well, actually, one can algebraize this, I mean, but it one can use initialization and so on, but anyway, uses this idea. And then, by working carefully with the ideas of almost mathematics, LFL things, one can also prove the third, the more stronger thing by analyzing the last method. So, okay, so maybe I... Okay.
Other questions?
Maybe. So you mentioned two methods at the end, one using the periodic vanishing cycle,
yes,
and one using Faltings and the
dispersion. Yes.
But in some sense, the question is, are they really different? In some sense, can you?
No, but because I say that I have this argument which uses the improvement of the stuff from the 80s about vanishing cycle, a small, okay, and some compatibility. I mean, you have to do a lot of compatibilities with the, to do foundations for this kind of cohomology with log, and so you have to work on this language and prove and prove compatibility with other maps. Then the other idea is to attach disks at infinity, to attach disks at infinity. So this will be now, you see, what you are doing is the cohomology supported in this. So this is like the relative cohomology of the world special fire modulo those A1. So this is like cohomology of a complete curve. So it doesn't use at all the precise study here. It uses more the study at infinity. So, so union some closed disks with constant coefficients. So the point is that on H2, so if you look at this H2, let's say over an algebraically closed field, then you have this one you know, but then you have H1 of U, which is not zero, but it is essentially, for a disk, it's it has to do with using so studying this modulo P to the end. So then here I can have some valuation filtration. And so again, I have a kind of filtration by things which are linear over K. And so this allows me to to control. Well, here I did not... Anyway, I have also the Galois cohomology of small k acting on this. So eventually I do the Galois cohomology for the separable closure and then the residue field. But the point is that you will, because of it will act linearly on some vector spaces, things which are essentially vector spaces of a residue field, Galois, just by usual Galois descent, it will be zero. Okay, so this, and then the ideas of almost mathematics, so to speak, is like what we heard in the today. So you can, instead of using algebraic closure, you can use just adding piece root of the, adding roots of unity and the piece root of the of representative p basis elements in the residue field. And then again, by some vanishing result, so you can reduce the Galois cohomology computation that you need here, because you're working with things, you can work with things which are evaluation less than something, and then you can use the faulting, I mean, essentially the what is anyway the almost the totalness, I mean the fact that this is kind of deeply ramified in the sense that further extensions are almost a total. Okay, so the pure, anyway, the, in this case, so I can so the point is that I can get the I have some, I can represent the classes in H1, well, actually cohomology of K with some H1D by certain, using only this extension, and then I can look at what it, I can see that it gives me contributions of K, I mean things in U1 because of the precise nature of the symbols which are involved. But anyway, this is recent, it could involve some mistakes, so I didn't, I have not, I think that the other thing which has two proofs must be sufficiently stable, and this one is only this proof, and maybe I only imagine that I can prove it, and I, so I don't know that, I cannot say that. But anyway, the idea is to improve the extension, I mean, to this kind of extension, then look at which symbols you get from the co-boundary, and then see it are in U1, and apparently, and I did not see a way to get it from the other, from the direct method of, so, I don't know, it's a...
More question?
Thanks, Gabber, and...